I just can't imagine going like, give me one good, are you ready? Sorry, I can't swear. Hello, my name is George Ezra and I'm about to react to some of my most iconic moments. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. So that's the video for Budapest. It's cool. That video is cool. We worked with a director called Rob, who I worked with on a few different videos, and he just did such an amazing job of kind of capturing that, the wonky side of everything going on. And it's easy to take that stuff for granted, but watching it back is, thank you, Rob. I look like a baby, but I remember it was a long day, but an enjoyable day. And I think some of the guys in the shoot were kind of Rob's friends. There was an air of that throughout, especially the first record, but through a lot of the stuff I've done, it's like get people involved that you know, friends and family, and then you can bolt more memories onto it to share. It won't surprise anyone to hear I do not crowd surf these days. I just can't imagine going like, give me one good, are you ready? Sorry, I can't swear. doesn't quite fit in. And do you know that image of just like the parting of the seas? I can imagine that happening. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like someone. See, that would be the crowd surf moment there. Oh man, so that's Glastonbury 2019. It's almost like the more people there are, the more relaxed you are, because it's easy to detach from it because it doesn't make sense. So then when you see it like that, it's like, what? Yeah, it's beautiful. It's very cool to see. That was the year I did my ankle in the morning of traveling to the Isle of Wight Festival, rolled my ankle. It was so swollen and painful. But then also what you did, so I ended up doing the festival season, sat on a stool, which was not the coolest thing, but hey-ho.
I mean, that's why you don't crowd surf, right?
There you go. Health and safety. This is an incredible honour, and thank you very much. There's not a day goes by that I don't consider myself very lucky, and this is the icing on the cake, so thank you very much. And of course, there's a load of people I need to thank. I'm not going to name anybody because I'll forget somebody, but to everybody that I get to work alongside, thank you very much for all of your hard work. And to everyone at home that comes to see us live and shares the music, it means the world from the bottom of my heart.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Mad that that's happened. I was bricking it. You're asked beforehand whether or not you want to know if you've won. And I did. I wanted to know. And even still, I failed to prepare anything that was too smooth. There was a lot of but it was a cool day, I guess. It was kind of in the middle of everything going on. There was a whole whirlwind going on. So I don't know how present I was at the time. I think I was in my head quite a bit. But amazing. And I've just come round to as well, I feel comfortable now having the Brit out at home. For the longest time it wasn't, but I like seeing it now.
Where do you keep it?
On a shelf.
Sorry, I didn't mean to be. It's in my spare room by where I work from. I think ours was the first or second award of the evening. I could be wrong. Maybe it was I was performing, so it was backstage, but it felt like it was over quite early in the night, which I was really grateful for. It's like when you're playing festivals, when they're like, and it's fantastic, you're playing last on Sunday. You're like, well, okay. And look, hey, if you want to book me for the last slot at any festival, I'll be there. But it's more just like Friday. What you want to do is open Friday and then get involved, ideally.
If you could redo your speech now, don't you
say? Are you f***ing ready? what would I say? Something along those lines. That is all you can say. It's like it is an incredible thing, and there's so many people that you work with that make it all happen and come together. And there's also, you know, we're talking a lot at the moment about the fact we're going back out on tour, and that can only happen if people show up.
So it's, I would say the same thing.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9, 9, 9. Wait, hold up. Ian.
Yes?
What's going on?
McKellen.
I'm trying to shoot a video for my song.
Well, I'm just trying to sing the song. It's such a fantastic song. Well,
thank you very much.
I think I sing it rather well.
I understand that, but it's just a frustration.
Do you know, Jeff, I love all your music. From Bucharest onwards.
Budapest. So that was Rob again that directed the Budapest video, and it was like, at first, the idea was that we would build an animatronic Venus flytrap and that would keep interrupting me. And then for whatever reason, we couldn't make that happen. And I was in a meeting in America and he rang me and he was like, Ian McKellen. I was like, dude, I can't talk. He was like, Ian McKellen, how do you feel about Ian McKellen? And I was like, what do you mean? We can't get, and he was like, we can get Ian McKellen in the video. Sure. I was really nervous for that bit. There was this bit where we had to kind of just go back and forth, but he was brilliant and it put me at ease and was really sweet. What a thing to have done.
Did you learn anything about him that surprised you?
He, like, genuinely, we were like in the canteen of the studios and he was so up for talking about Lord of the Rings. He was so proud of what he'd been a part of, which I don't think you always see. I think some people, you know, I'm more than just a character, I'm not just that. And he was really like, yeah, man, I did that. And that was cool.
I think, George, you can get into acting. I think you
can
do acting.
Oh, I don't know. Thank you. I think it's more because of him. I think he carries that scene, as it were. When I dance alone and the sun's beating
down, blazing on me. Again with the harmonies, just for the chorus especially, make sure it's just us two.
Right, because I just thought... I'm literally needs to do that.
But you'll see it's the same part. It's disgruntled young man being interrupted. That's what I do. Yeah. Yeah, man, that's amazing. Like, the fact that James Corden has got the gig that he's got and still champions, like, at this point, maybe there is no right. I have no right being on American TV in that way, and he does a good job of kind of opening the doors and getting us involved, which is amazing, actually. And he is a frustrated musician at heart, isn't he? Any opportunity, and he can sing. That's the thing, and he knows it. So, good on him.
Working with someone, Ellen, too. How was that?
Did Ellen, yeah. I remember me wanting to get a picture with Ellen because I felt like we looked similar and I don't think she digged that. Maybe I didn't ask her, but don't know. Again, it's all a blur. Oh, won't you come on home for Christmas, babe? Come on home for Christmas. Come on home for Christmas, babe. Come on home for Christmas. I'm so alone. Please come home. That was very cool. It was kind of like I hadn't done anything like that. I hadn't shot a video or anything like that in a long time. And then we got on set and I was like, this is cool. I can do this. It makes me laugh as well. At the very end, when I'm walking down the steps, there's a dude that I get to work with called Benj. And I was like, go on, get in a shot. So Benj walks down the stairs, which isn't funny to anyone else other than me. And I don't know if he found it that funny. I was just like, no, it's good. We'll know and no one else will. There you go. That made me laugh at the end of a long day. It's cool. Good Christmas songs are the best kinds of songs.
What can you tell us about your upcoming music?
What can I tell you about it? There's lots of it to come. There's an album coming, you know, and everything that comes with that, videos, singles, performances. End of February, we're playing in Edinburgh and Manchester. And then at the very beginning of March, we're playing at the Palladium in London. Got a big old gig at Finsbury Park later on in the year. I'm sure I'll be kept busy with touring.
And you're excited for those performances?
Yeah, it's more just not the specific performances, although there are reasons to get excited about them individually. It's just the idea of being performing again. And we've started rehearsing and even that feels good. There we go. That was me watching back some iconic moments. Dive in. New music, album coming. I hope you're well. See you soon.